First start of the season after bagging the equaliser against the Glory. Moving on to the Wanderers, there's three changes for Western Sydney as well, with Team Heffernan aiming for a better showing than in the 1-4 reverse to Newcastle Jets in round 4. Sarah Willis in sight from Adelaide United makes her Wanderers debut with goal, with Courtney Newborn reverting to the bench. In front of Willis, Tegan Collister makes her first start of 2021, as does 17-year-old Sarah Hunter, the youngster deployed on the right of what we believe will be a front three. Lara Lee in the middle, assisted by Lauren Ray and Georgia Girardello, the fourth official. Should be a cracking match. The crowd is building. Wanderers in their usual green. Now, Kendall Fletcher back skippering the side as well. Get someone that you know very well, Kevin Cooper, skippering the Wanderers. Former champion, I think, West, this Western City line. The former around there, maybe coming. Haven't scored a goal yet this season. Rather surprising for someone who's netted 43 times in this competition so far. And we're away at Viking Park. Plenty of late action at this venue throughout the year. For Keely Richards. And Nash put under pressure, taken away by Yeoman Tail. He's tugging the shirt there. It's come from Nevin. How important is it for Keely Richards to get an early touch? Could be a tale of two goalkeepers today. Sarah Willis is making her first start for the Wanderers. There'll be pressure from Canberra United to Miles McKinnon inside the area. Hughes will return. Cooper will bring away and find Carmis outnumbered out front. Are you surprised by the selection of Willis over Newbury?
Yeah, it's an interesting one. I think Newbury would have had another great start for this season, and she's made some improvements in her second year. But conversely, she's made a couple of errors.
Yeah. 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 stays down here. Nicky Fanny to stretch her legs and bear down on goal, and the first shot in angle of the match is coming from that one.
and just as it invited a bit too much of the
didn't see Hunter coming, did she? There again. She pick out the delivery this time, Nicky Flannery into the penalty area in the header. Just over the bar from Grace Harper. Great for the grab away, Fiona and Canberra, nice and quick and sharp going for this.
Run the replay.
Fantastic.
They've expected when they did it to comms team to get to Newcastle or Western Sydney and going out to all over the place once more.
That's right, it's certainly the one that we saw on the sheet that was United this year. They lost four of six home matches in 1920. Failed to make the finals for the third consecutive year, but they're unbeaten at home again. 1990s. We've both been involved in Canberra for a long time, perhaps not that long.
Well, that's why I went to the replay.
It's been a remarkable turnaround at home, hasn't it? They've certainly made Viking Park a fortress.
Well, that's a
mentioned at the top of the broadcast a couple of changes to the Canberra team today, but the back four is the same as it was last week. Four, well, Canberra rather, have only won one of the last four, one was a draw. as with most of these things though, it very matters little on the day. Putting a little bit of pressure on Canberra at the back at the moment. Fletcher has to get rid of it. And Queenan on the turn sends it down to Telly Telly. So discretion's the better part of valor there. Doesn't want to get in a foot race with Hayley Telly Young.
I would not want to either. I'm really safe play there.
Yeah,
so you saw Sheriff like Jones that, in goal last week here against Clough Gore. And a little birdie tells me that Canberra had a new midfielder training with him in midweek. Yeah, so one Grey Skill had donned the boots. No chance of a comeback then, Chris?
I don't think a comeback is on
the
table.
Might be at the upper limit for Kendall Fletcher in terms of distance. No doubt she has the quality to test there. I want to see here. Midfielder from it 13 times so far in her career. Eyes lit up over this one. Kendall Fletcher likely to try her luck from range. Obviously sorting out the wall. Kendall Fletcher over it. Clips it towards the far post instead. Two stools there. Looks for Grace Mars late run, I believe.
Very unselfish play there by Kendall Fletcher. But I would have liked to see the try and test Willis on that one and get that one on target.
To impose themselves on the contest.
Yeah, they certainly have, and what I've never seen today as well, we've got Caitlin Cooper back sitting in central defence, and last week they had a push further up the field. I don't think that's not sort of her great strength, or the great strength that she can really bring to the side. I think she's really valuable back in that centre-back line, controlling and marshalling the team in front of her.
Tell you, I'm Rob Tanser, finds Valletta. We've seen Lauren Keir play a couple of games this season at the back of the defence. This time, won by Morgan. Fulton Nevin. Price. Cooper. Morgan forced to go home. Squabble over the ball for the throw-in.
She'll probably get a bit of a talking to, and that might be it.
Laying down the law.
One. Take.
Kim's touch to herself. Cooper clears. Calls for Fletcher. Flannery on the turn. Open up for a brief second. For Letter. On the top of the penalty area. Good challenge by the Yeoman Dell, who's tracked back. Fletcher, who's been involved in most things in this opening 22 minutes. Here she is again.
Right, be ready.
Dictating things in the middle of the park. She's using that wealth of experience to find those little pockets of space. It's so important. All goes ball forward, and Yoski picks it off. Taylor Young finds it. Looking for Heyman. Slightly overhits. Heyman gives her a second chance. Members of the Mariners in the first season of the W League, if my memory serves me right. Before coming to Canberra, swung towards Flannery on the far post, just over his.
But I think it's a really well-deserved start. I think when a young player comes in and proves themselves and is able to put goals away, it's really well-deserved and pleasing to see him
getting an equaliser here as well, isn't it? She took it superbly. His price. Steps into the channel here by the way. Get on, get on. Pleasing from a Canberra point of view this season, Grayson. You might agree, is it? Their response to going behind in games has been genuinely very good. Shirts in and around the penalty area. It's all in the delivery. What can they do with it? Swung in towards the penalty area. Richards was looking for it. Carlos wins the header, and it's just wide. Hunter was a stud away from turning that home.
Carlos,
as you said, got away from the mark and correct ahead of Goldman's. Hunter wasn't far away though.
That's something that Carlos does so well. She is such an aerial threat.
And it's touch Flannery now. She's away here. Nicky Flannery on that right foot. Fast it dodges. Just a snapshot of the pace the Canberra United offer on the break, and something that we need to be wary of as we progress.
She will be disappointed with that, and that has to be on target for her, but she just got to saw that little stutter step before she struck it, and just really stabbed it for her, but not too far off.
In amongst that, was a nice touch of payment getting ready to one after the place here. Coming back into the game, the Wanderers have had an absolute sucker punch for that second goal. Fletcher.
Step! Step!
Nash. Stefan's allowed Haley Telly into the area here, looking for Heyman. Cooper scoops it away. Julian Russell should make the clearance. Just can't get it out at the moment. He shoots. Slides it through. Flannery in on goal. And Wilson was there. He's back in the run up anyway. Julian Russell wants to go back to Willisie. What's the perfect first half for Canberra United and Vicky Linton Grace?
Michelle Heyman, second here at Viking Park as well.
all their goals have come in this venue.
Eight red,
sorry, that is still cool.
Gigi clips it forward.
It's Paul here on forward.
Lost his touch. Curtis Brown. Once it goes backwards to Cooper. They're doing as good as they've got, really, haven't they? There's been three pieces of opportunism from Michelle Heyman. Three goals.
Thank you.
and you've got the scoring underway early on. And she hasn't stopped two more since then, and at the break, Canberra United are looking in a strong position at half-time here at Viking Park. Canberra United in control. We'll be back with all the action and analysis after this break. It's Canberra United 3, Western Sydney Wanderers 0.
Any spectator identified with a prohibited item or assessed as unduly intoxicated may be refused entry, evicted from the stadium, potentially banned from attending future matches, and handed over to police for further questioning. We ask you respect your fellow spectators by refraining from illegal and dangerous activities. Westfield are proud supporters of women's football and the official partner of the Westfield W League. Westfield unites local football communities by connecting fans to the game. Canberra United would like to thank its major
welcome
sponsors.
Welcome back to Viking Park in Canberra, sunny Canberra. But rain all week, but the sun is shining
the
here. It's shining for Michelle Hayden, who
offers the ultimate
set a history making first half. The most goals to one club in the W League now with 58, which is on level with Sam Kerr at the top of the all-time scoring charts with 17. It's not all been about Michelle Hayden, but it's hard to not talk about the hat-trick.
His multiple locations across the ACC and regional New South Wales. Finding their club line close to home for work is easy. The University of Canberra, UC is ranked among the top 100 young unis in the world and consistently delivers 89% graduate employment and above average graduate starting salary. Cheeky's, new to the Canberra United family in 2020-21, Cheeky was established in 2009 and were the first Australian brand to introduce stainless steel water bottles to the market. They are here to change the world in the most positive way possible with products that are made for life.
This is perhaps one of the best in the first half year on the Delphine Carmen.
DKD Consulting. Consulting is an Australian small to medium enterprise consisting of former defence APS, military and defence contractors. DKG specialists have a combined experience of over 50 years specialising in programs, projects, ICT, and cybersecurity, records and commercial management services. Canberra Milk, they have been operating in Griffith for over 47 years, which is why Canberra Milk is proudly ours since 1971. Atella, as the official apparel partner of Canberra United for the Westfield WB 2020-21 season, Atella can be counted on under the toughest situation in harshest conditions. Lennox Hyundai are the preferred automotive partner of Canberra United, providing the club, players and supporters with great deals on great cars from the Hyundai brand. Canberra Rex Hotel. Built in 1959 as the luxury hotel in the nation's capital, the Canberra Rex has stood as an iconic landmark for over 55 years, a home away from home for accommodations and celebrations enjoyed by all. Performance Travel. Performance Travel is the official travel partner and away-game sponsor of Canberra United Football Club. Going on a holiday in both sports? Contact the team at Performance Travel and they will help you out. Win TV, the Win Network is Australia's largest regional commercial television network, broadcasting to more of regional Australia than any other regional commercial network. And Canberra FM, Canberra FM Radio, a joint venture between Southern Cross Stereo and the Australian Radio Network. It's home to 104.7 and 90.3. Canberra FM joins the Canberra United family as a media partner for the 2020 Westfield WB season. Canberra United would like to thank the members of our Business United Club, Canberra Foot and Ankle Clinic. Founded by principal podiatrist Carl Denny in 2019, CFAC has quickly become one of Canberra's premier family and sports podiatry clinics.
Still 45 minutes to go, of course, and anything could happen in the WB, as we've seen it before, but at the end of all here at the moment, it's Michelle Heyman with the treble that has Canberra United looking good at the moment. Top of the table, we'll be back in the second half.
Beaumont Concreting specializes in house labs, garages and driveways for single dwelling homes to multi-unit developments. Canberra United would like to thank the members of our Business United Club, Standard Hall and Gallup, Storage King Belconnen, and Viz Australia. Are you part of the Canberra United Canberra Milk Kids Club? If you are not a Canberra Milk Kids Club member, visit www.canberrauniteds.com.au for more info on this exclusive club for kids aged 5 to 12, which includes a special t-shirt and special events. And just one more reminder, guys,
to keep everyone safe
from COVID-19, please ensure to do the following. Check in via the QR code with the check-in CPR app. Stay seated where possible. Remain in your groups and remember to socially distance from others. Wash or sanitize your hands frequently. And if you start to feel unwell, please leave the venue immediately.
I'm Valuable little connection.
making passes and taking touches in. She's had a tough job today, but
chance for them to add to the tally. And they will be hungry to add to that tally, of course, as well. Such a condensed table, goal difference might be important. Fletcher over the set piece. Grace Myers gone short has the option and peeling away. Fletcher delivers into the area, good 1-2. Carness was back with the header. Indecisiveness in defence. Nevin got rid of it. Carness can bring it forward. No changes by either side of half time. We'll continue to have Briley Henry, Danica Matos, Rosie Gillia, and Isabel Gomez as our outfield options. Rosie Gillia with a couple of goals for him.
Thank you. Austin.
Playing around.
Pretty good. That's just fantastic. We get two heads around. Pick that one out of the back of the second. Fantastic second.
Cooper's grabbed Brown. Must have been scored once it came off the foot. Meanwhile, here's Michelle Hayman. Folletta. Looking for the run of Grace Marr, who snuck in on the blind side here. Julianne Russell holding the back of her neck there, so she fell awkwardly. She makes an interesting deployment of her as a right back this afternoon. Mars brought in, lovely ball. Flannery's got guard sides. Pulls it back towards Shoes. Quite work. And for a moment, Flannery is going to pull the trigger.
Yeah.
got signs of life though.
And then from there,
yeah, if you go wide, though, it won't.
Yeah.
It should be all right, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Because then you see, that's a shot.
She had a quiet first half.
Yeah,
it's right. Yeah, so it's a second half space. A good save from Richardson. Snuck in behind on that occasion.
Well, you won't be. Yeah,
but it's not really wide. Maybe as she goes on to the
floor, she's on the blue purple ground. Runner outside is Collister. Still slightly too much. On a cooler day, maybe. Something happening here, Lara Lee. So, stop the game. Two players at the opposite ends of their playing career, you would suggest. Thomas probably got plenty of years left in the US. That's a really good striker. Against the 16-year-old centre back.
Yeah.
Okay,
might have a corner. Briley Henry is about to join the fray imminently. Third Wanderers change. Won't do it before this corner kick though, which Kendall Fletcher is placing.
Yeah, but then when you went
looking into the sun, is Sarah Willis in the defence? It's come to the edge of the box for Hughes. We thought about the shot, now lines one up and visited Gorwood, and that's a stunning save from Willis. Great hit from Hughes, and Willis plunging to her leg. Hughes out onto the top. Danger not over for Western State Wanderers. Grace Marr over the corner from the other side. This one swung in towards the near post. Cooper wins the header. Hughes finds Marr.
Yeah, just sort of pulled in.
Hughes. Marr lifts it into the penalty area towards Flannery. Collister wins the header. Keir tries to help it back in. Comes for Follett.
Is that the best save we've got?
Grace Marr just decides to start again. Nash. The Wanderers out of their defensive shell. Mark Fletcher.
Shot,
Brown snaps back into the challenge with Grace Marr, who's brought it to by Hughes. All over the top towards Briley Henley. And that is a sweeper keeping. The situation perfect.
Just relieves any pressure immediately. Looking really confident, really comfortable.
Passes it again. Nash sends it forward. Hughes is touch. Campbell will look to build again. Here's the changes for Canberra United. Who's been for Letta coming in to take? Bianca Galic. Michelle Heyman. Making way for Kevin Kilazaki. No level breaking this ball. She played her part.
It's good to start off on the floor and pan down maybe. It's just because we don't get something every
looking for Henry. So
the subs
if it's disappointing. First signs of a miscommunication at the back there. It's not that.
Just the one angle of this one.
Yeah, well, that's
what coming back to one. Come in. Nice.
First involvement for Kulazak, which is a good one. He just wins it wide for Flannery, who's taking up station on his third side.
Yes, three!
Ilioski. Flannery.
Yeah, no, that works.
Ma finds Ilioski again.
Tuck in, Coots, get across, Nicky!
Couldn't run out to go.
Get across!
Canberra United leading by those three first-half goals, all scored by Michelle Henry, who's now departing the scene. Job done from her point of view. Cooper tries to play it forwards.
Julian Russell and Kaiser, that's just such a regular experience on this Wanderer side, and
chase the game and turn things around. If you need that experience on the field to be able to do that.
Yeah, I'm wondering how, as we mentioned earlier in the call, about how much notice they've had of the game and how prepared they were for this match, and whether, you know, the training load was a bit different this week.
Look, it may well have been, but I think some of the
attitude of everyone involved, from players, visual supporters and broadcasting staff, has been top notch.
Very much so, and I think we don't want to acknowledge the quality of this game.
To the penalty. I thought about the shots. Let's come back to Jessie Rashard, reinventing herself as a Ronaldo figure out on the wing. She was caught in two minds whether to shoot them or try and find a colleague. A couple of players down here. Wondrous. Couple of shots. Ken Cooper stretching.
Two on there. Yeah, the
little shift that Sarah Hansen's put in as well. It's surprising she's got a little bit of cramp. It's nothing more than that for her sake. 17-year-old making a second appearance in the competition today. You wouldn't believe that, would you? Same could be said of Ilioski as well. Damage was done in the first half as we enter the final 7 minutes. All three goals coming from Michelle Heyman inside the first stanza. Left the 4th minute left for Thunderbolts, and much right foot plant from Nicky Flannery. Square ball after 34 minutes, and then that left-footed coach's instinct 3 minutes before the break. And they're the goals that have Canberra United rocketing third to first on the W League over this evening. Sum up the Wanderers afternoon, just after they make their 4th substitution. They lose it there. Strange and Grace, we mentioned it in the first half, it's a 3-0 result for Canberra at the moment, and they're comfortably 3-0, but it's not been a comfortable game.
No, I think it's been, I don't think the margin of the score has necessarily
Who is off his back to help out and his back.
back to one.
Sorry. So that has scored goals in a local NPL competition.
Mostly headers on the corner. I had a sound.
Coaching stuff about coming this year, maybe Jesse Rashard's reinventing himself as a forward player. He's going to get back and lend aerial ability to this defensive effort though for a corner. Is there a consolation that all the ones on one? Swung in towards Richards, who's just in the square. Well taken, and pulls it out towards Satchel. There's quite a bit of space here. So he's trying to stretch from Aces and touch. Was well seen. Something and here's Rosie Gallier. Swinging into the penalty area, and it's deflected off of Ilioski.
Inches away from an own goal.
I
think it's 10 matches between these two. We've seen one just where they've come to get 3 own goals. The camera's across. Still giving a go. Seconds play before the match. It's been a Canberra United performance. It's going to put on top of the league. Grayson, what you've seen from all teams in the competition so far, are there good a chance as anybody?
Look, I think after the South Sea first half, I have to say yes, I think they played some really good composed football. I think it dictated the pace of this play.
Even though almost
no goals. A bit of frustration coming in.
Defensively sound, they look creative, and they've got a goal scorer in prime form. Really brilliant switch normally. Something good. On the back foot here at the moment, so Sakamis is chasing in towards that one and skips through. So Richardson is seconds away from a clean sheet on debut. Can't ask for more than that. It's Kiri Richards, and that is what's debut clean sheet for Richards, the hat trick player, Michelle Heyman. 3 points for Canberra United in a game in which they put to bed in the first 45 minutes.
That concludes tonight's match with the score of Canberra United 3-2 Western Sydney Wanderers. We hope you enjoyed the match and thank you for your participation in today's match. Stay tuned to Canberra United website and socials for when our next home match.